Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Sorry about the shutter and the lighting. Today I'm going to be showing you how I make a laminated dashboard for my B6 Slim. So it's like a cover for an insert. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use this pen and this ruler. I'm going to measure out 4.5 inches by 7.5. I know that B6 Slim is by 7 tall, but there's a reason why. So I'll show you, I'll measure it at, go in a bit, I'll start at 1 inch, 4.5 is 5.5, plus another 1, 2, 3, 4.5, so 10. While I'm doing this, I also have my laminator on the side heating up, just for when this is ripping. I hope the shadow isn't so bad. Please do bear with me. It's 8 o'clock in the morning. Grab my Stanley knife. I'm just going to cut off where I've outlined. Now I have these two sheets. Okay. I'm just going to cut the 7.5 mark. So that is 7.5 by 4.5. The 7 mark might go down 1.5, and come down to the 4 mark. what I'm going to do is on this sheet, again, it's still the same sheet and it's got two parts. I'm just going to draw an arch here. So this will turn out to be a poppet. Okay, like so. I'm just going to get the other side, place that on top, and just trace over it. So the pockets will be some like identical. It's wearing off a bit, but okay. It's not a really good marker. Okay. So now that I've done that, I'm going to grab this one and you want to separate them. Okay, so the inside's the glue part, the outside's the slick part. So to make the pocket, you want the slick parts together so they don't actually glue together. Like so. I'll do the same for this one, except I'll turn. I'll flip this side over like that. So the pocket, they both face inwards like that. The glue part. Okay, that's the glue part, that's the slip part. So you want the glue part on the outside and the slip part on the inside. Okay, like so. So I've got the pockets facing inwards and I've got the glue parts on the outside. I'm going to put them aside. I'm going to grab a bigger piece of laminate sheet. And I'm going to place these inside like so. I'm going to leave a slight gap so this sheet here will act as the binding of the two pockets. Like so. So now I'm going to put this over the top and I will laminate it. Please bear with me, it is a slow process. So now you have a full clear laminate sheet with the pockets. So now what I'm going to do is this is the line of the pockets here, and I'm going to measure 7 inches. 'm sorry if there's glare too from the laminate. Okay. And now to make sure that I don't cut on the pockets, I'm going to go just mark just outside of that edging there. All the way around. Cut along those lines. Straight. I'm cutting with laminate and a ruler. Sometimes it's not always perfect because it does slide around. So now I'm going to cut on this 7 inch mark. So even though the pocket ends here, this will allow the air to go into the pocket to create them. Like so. Okay. Just making sure that that line is on the same side. So what I'm going to do is grab a piece of paper, one of the thicker pieces of paper that I have. I'm just going to fold it like so. What I'm going to do is place the piece of paper inside, because when I do the scoring, I don't want to cut the laminate all the way through. So what I'm going to do is make sure that this is close to the edge as possible, and just score it with the Stanley knife. Now what I'm going to do is this will rip off there. Then I'm going to grab the scissors. Take that out. Just cut a neat line down to that cut. And there you've got that pocket. And I'm going to do the same on the other side. There you have your B6 Slim, 4.5 inches by 7 inches tall, with your two pockets. And I'm just going to show you how that fits around an insert, but first I will train it to fold inwards. Grab my Maverick. And that just goes in behind the insert like that. And there, you have a clear plastic folder to protect your inserts. Thank you for watching.